my Lord suffered for me, carried the cross all the way, my sins he atoned. And they nailed him to the cross, great was the pain and the loss, suffered it all because he loved me. Because he loved me, my Savior died, on a cross was crucified. No greater love by mortal man has ever been known. Praise his dear name, he loved me so. Now I am his, he's mine, I know. Suffered it all because he loved me. Suffered it all because he loved me. Suffered it all because he loved me.
Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. His mercy endures forever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, in your tender love for us, you sent your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, to take upon himself our nature, and to suffer death upon the cross, giving us the example of his great humility. Mercifully grant that we may walk in the way of his suffering, and come to share in his resurrection, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. St. Peter denied his Jesus one cold and lonely night. He said he never knew him, a rock and lost his mind. But Jesus looked upon him with eyes of perfect love. Peter's heart was broken, he wept to God above. Oh, the cry from the cross, forgive him, blessed Father. He cried from the cross, oh, he cried from the cross. The Son of God was dying to save the world from loss. Next morning in Jerusalem, about the break of dawn, a trial was in session. God's will would soon be done. They scorned him and they mocked him and crowned him with sharp thorns. On top of Calvary's mountain, they crucified our Lord. Oh, the cry from the cross, forgive him, blessed Father. He cried from the cross, oh, he cried from the cross. The Son of God was dying to save the world from loss. Father, it is finished. He bowed his head and died. The world was left in darkness. The graves were open wide. An earthquake shook Jerusalem. The veil fell to the ground. The multitude was frightened. The dead walked into town. Oh, the cry from the cross, forgive him, blessed Father. He cried from the cross. Oh, he cried from the cross. The Son of God was dying to save the world from loss. Oh, the cry from the cross, forgive him, blessed Father. He cried from the cross. Oh, he cried from the cross. The Son of God was dying to save the world from loss.
The plot to kill Jesus. It was now 2 days before the Passover and the Feast of the Unleavened Bread, and the chief priests and scribes were seeking how to arrest him by stealth and kill him. Or they said, not during the feast, lest there be an uproar from the people. The Passover with the disciples. And the disciples set out and went to the city and found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. And when it was evening, he came with the 12. And as they were reclining at table and eating, Jesus said, truly I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me. They began to be sorrowful and to say to him one after another, is it I? He said to them, it is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the dish with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had not been born. Institution of the Lord's Supper. And as they were eating, he took bread, and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to them and said, take, this is my body. And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks and gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I say unto you, I will not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God. Jesus foretells Peter's denial. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them, you will all fall away, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee. Peter said to him, even though they all fall away, I will not. And Jesus said to him, truly I tell you, this very night, before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me 3 times. But he said emphatically, if I must die with you, I will not deny you. And they all said the same. Betrayal and arrest of Jesus. And immediately, while he was still speaking, Judas came, one of them, and with him a crowd with swords and clubs, from the chief priests and the scribes and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Seize him and lead him away under guard." And when he came, he went up to him at once and said, "Rabbi," and he kissed him. And they laid hands on him and seized him. But one of those who stood by drew his sword and struck the servant of the high priest and cut off his ear. And Jesus said to them, "Have you come out as against a robber with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled." And they all left him and fled. Jesus before the council. Now the chief priests and the whole council were seeking testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many bore false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. And some stood up and bore false witness against him, saying, "We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.' Yet even about this their testimony did not agree. And the high priest stood up in the midst and asked Jesus, 'Have you no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you?' But he remained silent and made no answer. And the high priest asked him, 'Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed?' And Jesus said, 'I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming with the clouds of heaven.' And again the high priest tore his garments and said, 'What further witnesses do we need? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?' And they all condemned him as deserving death. And some began to spit on him and to cover his face and to strike him, saying to him, 'Prophesy.' And the guards received him with blows." Peter denies Jesus. And as Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came, and seeing Peter warming himself, she looked at him and said, "You also were with the Nazarene, Jesus." But he denied it, saying, "I neither know nor understand what you mean." And he went out into the gateway, and the rooster crowed. And the servant girl saw him and began again to say to the bystanders, "This man is one of them." But again he denied it. And after a little while the bystanders again said to Peter, "Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean." But he began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear, "I do not know this man of whom you speak." And immediately the rooster crowed a second time. And Peter remembered how Jesus had said to him, "Before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me 3 times." And he broke down and wept. Jesus delivered to Pilate. And as soon as it was morning, the chief priest held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. And they bound Jesus and led him away and delivered him over to Pilate. And Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" And he answered him, "You have said so." And the chief priest accused him of many things. And Pilate again asked him, "Have you no answer to make? See how many charges they bring against you." But Jesus made no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed.
On the day of the feast, a favor was given. One man must die, and one would keep living. When asked of the crowd, "Which man will it be?" they cried out my name so I could go free. I am Barabbas. He died in my place. I'm filthy with sin, covered by grace. I've nothing to bargain, I've nothing to give. I am Barabbas, yet now I can live.
Jesus
back then. I'm sentenced to die because of my sin. The Lord asked the question, which way will it be? I call out his name so I can go free. I am Barabbas, he died in my place. I'm filthy with sin, yet covered by grace. I've nothing to pardon, I've nothing to give. I am Barabbas, yet now I can live.
Pilate delivers Jesus to be crucified. Now at the feast, he used to release for them one prisoner for whom they asked. And among the rebels in prison, who had committed murder in the insurrection, there was a man called Barabbas. And the crowd came up and began to ask Pilate to do as he usually did for them. And he answered them, saying, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?" For he perceived that it was out of envy that the chief priests had delivered him up. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release for them Barabbas instead. And Pilate again said to them, "Then what shall I do with the man you call the king of the Jews?" And they cried out again, "Crucify him." And Pilate said to them, "Why, what evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released for them Barabbas. And having scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. Jesus is mocked. And the soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters. And they called together the whole battalion. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on him. And they began to salute him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they were striking his head with a reed, and spitting on him, and kneeling down in homage to him. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, and put his own clothes on him. And they led him out to crucify him.
It's the story so unkind. In the holy book we find, it tells how Jesus stood alone one day, false accused and there condemned. Yet they found no fault in him, the man who wore the scarlet purple robe. Purple robe my Savior wore, oh, the shame for me he bore, as he stood alone forsaken on that day. And they placed upon his head piercing thorns of bloodstained red. His raiment was a scarlet purple robe. In the common judgment hall, he was mocked and scorned by all, and a tear of sorrow fell upon his face. Soldiers of the wicked man smote him with their evil hand, the man who wore the scarlet purple robe. Purple robe my Savior wore, oh, the shame for me he bore, as he stood alone forsaken on that day. And they placed upon his head piercing thorns of bloodstained red. His raiment was a scarlet purple robe. Words of truth that day were plain from the lips of Pilate came, in This man, I see no reason he should die. But the multitudes replied, let him now be crucified. The man who wears the scarlet purple robe. Purple robe my Savior wore, oh, the shame for me he bore, as he stood alone forsaken on that day. And they placed upon his head piercing thorns of bloodstained red. His raiment was a scarlet purple robe.
The Crucifixion. And they compelled a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. And they brought him to the place called Golgotha, which means place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him, and divided his garments among them, casting lots for them to decide what each should take. And it was the third hour when they crucified him. And the inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two robbers, one on his right and one on his left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying, "Aha, you who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." So also the chief priests with the scribes mocked him to one another, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down now from the cross, that we may see and believe." The death of Jesus. And when the sixth hour had come, there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" And some of the bystanders hearing it said, "Behold, he is calling Elijah." And someone ran and filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." And Jesus uttered a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. And when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was the Son of God." There were also women looking on from a distance, among whom were Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James the Younger, and of Joseph, and Salome. When he was in Galilee, they followed him and ministered to him, and there were also many other women who came up with him to Jerusalem. Jesus is buried. And when evening had come, since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also looking for the kingdom of God, took courage and went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate was surprised to hear that he should have already died, and summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he was already dead. And when he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the corpse to Joseph. And Joseph brought a linen shroud, and taking him down, wrapped him in the linen shroud, and laid him in a tomb that had been cut out of the rock. And he rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, saw where he was laid.
Three men on a mountain, up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Three men on a mountain, up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. The man on the left was a sinner man. Tied to the cross he bled. He could have been forgiven, but he mocked the Lord instead. They say you are the Son of God, but they nailed you to the tree. Come down and save us, if God your Father be. Three men on a mountain, up on Calvary, and the man the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Three men on a mountain, up on Calvary. And the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Was a sinner too, but he's sorry for his sins. He begged the Lord forgiveness, and Jesus said to him, fear not this earthly death. Before this day is o'er, you'll be with me in paradise on heaven's golden shore. Up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Three men on a mountain, up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Three men on a mountain, up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me.